This is set number two on Ensk Myth front mission as the blue side started down south.
Yep, and here we go, just a pretty standard lineup from both sides as well. A little surprising from front mission, but then again, because it's front mission, I'm not that surprised either. Like with that 1390, just Ripper with the light tank. Otherwise, it's a pair of Ice Fees and a pair of 5100. Now on the other side, it's pretty much standard Immortals, pretty much like the same set, a pair of 5100 and three IS3s.
Yeah, nothing too surprising here. That Borsig definitely not going to be... at least we're not going to see this that tank specifically in this matchup, because I guess these teams just don't have enough practice.
Yeah, exactly. And besides, if you don't see it on Himmelsdorf and on Ends, chances are you won't see it on Bloomberg either.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
There you go. And Ripper cracking the first shot here, taking out the T1. A strong presence from Mythfront Mission towards the Eastern Forest, as a matter of fact, down south, whereas their opponents are clearly favoring the inner city.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is classic Immortals. Just go for the area with the most cover, the most kind of, options for your team, and then just kind of slowly progress.
Tanks.
Exactly.
Tanks,
so I wouldn't be surprised if the Immortals, you know, slowly kind of progress
They're
out
gonna push.
South. At
They're
the same push. Time, though, they have to be careful of this Eastern presence of Mythfront Mission, because if they leave this unchecked and if they don't spot any of this happening, and if they go for a push, they're gonna have their base completely open.
All they have to do is leave like 150-100. That's
yeah.
pretty much it.
Yeah.
You know what? Although they lost to T1, I still give the edge to the Immortals.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
because they own the city right now. They own the city, and they've got the other T1 like to the northeast, so they will detect this push ultimately. And all they have to do is send like perhaps two tanks for the capture down south, and it's gonna be enough.
Oh, but Ripper here clearing out this northern area here. He's going to be able to spot that
yeah,
T1.
Yeah, he does spot that T1,
yeah.
So he's going to take out like Linderman.
Yep,
Heinz going down here. There you go. Both T1s going down on the front mission side, but still, it doesn't change anything because the city is being completely monopolized by the Immortals.
Yep, and look at this move coming out from Myth front mission. They're actually pulling back.
I like that.
I like that too, because I think what they're doing now is because Ripper had to expose himself to take out that T1, now, I guess they're baiting the Immortals into thinking that they're still over there to the eastern
side.
They're
going to go for Railroad push,
yeah,
I think.
Or the city.
Perhaps the city, but
I think Railway is safer for this moment.
Yeah, because if they push towards Railway, they can still defend their own base down south because it's a straight shot, and they can still put a lot of pressure on the northern base while maintaining cover.
Yeah.
So I think that's an excellent choice coming from front mission.
Yeah.
It's not giving them a clear advantage, but in terms of because they still have both T1s alive, they do have more options than their opponents. Now, you know, knowing the Immortals, they're not going to budge. They're not going to budge until they know exactly what's going on anymore. So as long as the Immortals don't come out of cover and don't split forces, they're still safe.
Yeah, definitely. They do have the heavier setup as well. So
exactly.
If this is an even, just 100%, just go either way, definitely the Immortals having a slight advantage. And I don't know, Ripper, you know, in his AMA 13, although he got both those T1s, you know, it comes to a firefight, I'm just kind of skeptical on how much damage he can actually deal.
I know, but the thing is, it's just what really can turn the tide around for front mission is, you know, the fight getting drawn out and rather close and sending both P1s for a capture.
Yeah, with the AMX 13 kind of going back and forth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So all they have to do is just like make sure that during that firefight they survive long enough and take perhaps like two tier 8s, and then it's going to force the Immortals to split up to eventually defend their own base.
Yep.
So I think they're banking on that at the moment. But the Immortals very smartly are not budging.
Yeah, at least for now, because they have no T1s, they have no vision.
Exactly, and the thing is, they know they've got the advantage within the city. As long as they stay within the city, they're going to have the advantage when it comes to firefights. So very wisely, so they choose not to budge.
Yeah, and slowly but surely, Calliope, and I think it's the other IS3, right behind him. He is trying to progress up here to the northern part of the map. Just trying to get some more vision as well. The AMX 13 Ripper there on the front mission side down to the southwestern part of the map. You guys can't see it on your map right now.
Yeah, he's way down, like right now they can.
Yeah, okay,
he's way down. I think they're just trying to coordinate their offense right now because it's going to be, you know what, like that 1390, basically Ripper. If he comes to the nick of time as a flank to the northwest, he really, really might make all the difference in the world.
So that's his finisher?
Yeah, exactly. It's just very well played by front mission right now.
At least so far. As long as their strategy is not given away too soon, this push should work out for them. Both Calliope and Help Me Please have made it into this northern positioning here.
The risk is that they're really spread thin.
Yeah, they're in the right position right now. And as long as they don't give away this positioning here, and as long as both Help Me Please and Calliope stay alive long enough for those AMX 50s and the AMX 13 to come in here, they should be fine. But look at this, Immortals know this is happening.
Yeah, the Sirius taking a lot of punishment though. He goes down. He goes down. The Sirius went down, so this is an overwhelming advantage now for Front Mission. And look at that, you've got that MX-13 like flanking right now as we speak as well. So
Hades about to go down too.
Yeah, and Ripper just coming from behind. This is very well done.
Yeah,
I was really not favoring the Front Mission chances, but I gotta say they're playing this to perfection.
Yeah.
Look at that surrounding maneuver. Neverbest is getting shot from three different angles right now.
Yeah. Most definitely Front Mission art.
And Hades are gonna go down. Hades
dominant
going
position,
down.
Yeah.
This is a win.
Yeah, definitely.
This is a win.
That pushed the Immortals were just a little bit too passive. I think they should have moved a little bit more southern in the city, because in their position that they were in,
they could still have defended our base. I agree.
But their current position that they were in and the position that they were camping in, it allowed Front Mission to come to the side.
Surround them. And Ripper like coming from behind, definitely finishing the job. And this is an overwhelming victory for Myth. Well done.
Yeah, still not losing single. Or they finally lose Calliope there, but it's still not going to be nearly enough for anything.
Yeah, Iron Buzz is the next one to go down. There you go. Boom. Goodbye, Iron Buzz. Like, Boom T is going to take care of him. I think he's not even going to waste a shot. The Ram's going to get out. There you go. And the Savage now, the lone tank remaining, and he will not last.
All right, so awesome job.